good.
Hello, little boy. He's jumped up to see me.
Hello, precious boy.
He's so mucky.
He got so dirty out in the park today.
Oh my god, it should be illegal to be this cute.
So today, it's actually quite a nice sunny day out, but I just had an exciting appointment with a surgeon about my boobs. So I have decided that I want to get my boobs redone. Sorry, I can't stop staring at Hendrix. He's so cute. Like, just look at him sitting there. He's so scruffy. Oh my god, look at you. But yeah, so I've decided that I want to get my boobs redone. Just because, like, so I got them done. Excuse me, I'm just standing here in my pants because I'm just into the toilet. But yeah, my boobs, I had them done like 10 years ago, nearly. And I just feel that now I'm just like not super happy with the size anymore. I want to go a little bit smaller. I just find that when wearing certain tops, like I get sick of always having to size up and everything on my top half. Oh, one second. Sorry, that was a delivery. But yeah, it's been 10 years and I initially got them to the size and to correct symmetry because one was like quite like considerably bigger than the other. But now I'm like 30, I'm like, I kind of want them to be a little bit smaller. I'm like an F cup at the moment and I ideally like to be like a double D. So like I want to go down like maybe like one or two cup sizes. So that would be the ideal situation. So anyway, I went to see a surgeon today. I'm gonna go see a couple surgeons about this. But I was excited to see him and talk about it. And he was like, you know, your boobs are really good. He's like, they're really good. But he was like, you know, what we can do is we can work on a few things. So I'm excited to see how this goes. If I have them done, it will not be until like October in like later in the year. But I'm really excited. So that's something that is kind of happening. So I kind of want to show you like what I mean. Like I love this mirror because it was like it makes me look way better than I actually do. But yeah, so like if we like turn around, like they're just very big and I'm like, I'm a little bit like over it. Like I'm just a bit over it now.
Okay, so I'm just grooming Hendrix. He hates it so much. Sorry for the penis shot. Hendrix, I'll show you in a minute. So if you guys have been around a while, you'll remember Hendrix had alopecia X, which is like another name for black skin disease. It's really common in Pomeranians and it can occur for like different reasons. One being cutting their fur too short. Like I let the groomers cut his fur too short.
He developed it in a couple patches again. So I'm having to like follow a very, very, very strict grooming protocol. And it's brushing every day. And it's also applying this special lotion. He has been to the vets about it. I'll show you properly like what I mean by his fur. Okay, let me show you. So he has got this like strip here and it's been going through his skin treatment, which is a lotion called Dermagic. So that's been, I've been applying it like every day for a few months now. And this patch here, you'll see this little bit here. So this is all new fur that's growing through. So I'll show you like a picture of what this looked like a month ago. So it's all going through the right stages. It's just an annoying process. All done. We're done now. You can go. You can go, little boy. It's very early morning. I thought I would take you through my morning routine at the moment. It's usually a no phones zone. I have like a phone ban for at least the first hour when I get up because basically I realized that every time I woke up in the morning, I was just going on my phone. Like I'd wake up at like probably 8-ish, go scrolling on my phone for at least half an hour. And it was just such a shit start to the morning for me. Like it didn't do anything good for my mental health. It wasn't productive. Yeah, it's very early. I am sitting in my kitchen. I'll kind of talk through what I do. So I've got my coffee, I've got my Kindle and it's like, I don't know what, like six-ish in the morning. It's a bit of a rubbish day today, so there's no real sunrise or anything happening, which sucks, but usually it's nice to kind of look and I see like a sunrise
kind of just where those cranes are. It's like, you know, absolutely stunning, obviously, London.
So yeah, I have my notebook and I have my Kindle, and every day I've kind of been working on doing a gratitude practice. So I write in my notebook 10 things I'm grateful for that day. Some days are easy, some days are hard if I'm having a bit of a shit start to the day, but it's always to kind of like try and like tune things in to being a better start of the day. It's not even like I believe that, oh yeah, like I'm gonna manifest and like bring everything to me just by thinking positively. It's not even about that. Like for me, it's always like kind of shifting my mindset. Gratitude is really important, but also I will also caveat this with the fact that like I have gone through like severe bouts of depression where people would say to me, oh, just like write what you're grateful for and it'll just make you feel better. And honestly, when you are in the throes of depression, nothing makes you feel even worse like sitting down and writing down what you're grateful for, because like that just makes you feel worse, because you're like, oh my god, I am so like, I'm so ungrateful because I have all these things to be grateful for, but I'm really depressed still. But for me, I do find that in general it really works and it makes me feel really good. So this is literally what my morning is.
Oh, I also light incense because I just feel like it helps and it makes me feel like I'm in Bali. So today's incense is fortune, because I want to manifest being a rich motherfucker.
Okay, workout time. So I do my friend Lucy Mountain's NOBS, N O B S, stands for no bullshit or no burpees, you know, if that's what you want to do as well, because there's no burpees in it, which I fucking love because I hate burpees so much.
Fuck, I've just driven to my appointment and like this light came on during the drive and I think I have a flat tire. I called my dad and he thinks I have a flat tire, so I need to go have a look. I feel like it's this one. How am I meant to tell? I can never tell. Oh yeah, no, that one's definitely not looking like this one. Oh shit. So I just bumped into T. He thought I was just doing a photo shoot of my car. But
it's been a while. This is my like project stuff. We've got an awards thing. So.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say it looks like a Zara pass.
No, I wish. There's nothing
in
here.
Oh my god. But yeah, so what do you think it is?
I think the axle or the back's dropped.
Is that expensive?
Yeah. Oh, fuck. It could be that it's a setting that you do have in your car that's automatically lower.
Oh.
And it's just malfunctioning.
Oh, okay. Right. Okay. Chop me up a bit more. Okie dokie. We're here for my facial appointment. My skin's not doing too well at the minute. I'm during my period, so I've had a lot of bad breakouts, like juicy ones, so.
CR peel today.
CR peel.
So we're doing a resurfacing treatment. Resurfacing. So basically I don't want a needle, any of this active acne, because you can spread it. Yeah. Nice resurfacing treatment designed at taking down inflammation, taking down that redness.
So what are we putting on now?
So this is a sensitivity test. So basically I'm just seeing how well your skin can handle this, and that will determine how long we leave the next step on for.
So we've now got the actual peel going on. So this is what's gonna resurface my skin and make it feel and look better. Well, it'll look worse before it looks better probably. So.
Yeah.
But that's fine.
How spicy is it feeling now?
It doesn't really feel like anything anymore.
Good, so it's worn off.
Yeah.
Perfect.
So I'm gonna go now. I'm gonna go back to the Astra Clinic, get some paper and make a note on my car to let them know that I've broken down and it's not, I'm not paying for parking, like I've broken down. So yeah, hopefully I'll be fine. Guys, this is so cruel. I got this, I was just getting my note
and I came running back over with my note, and yeah, the guy was giving me a ticket.
So embarrassing. Everyone's seeing me with the yellow parking charge of doom. I actually can't believe that. Like, I ran over to him and was like, no, I was like, please don't give me a ticket, I have a note. He was okay with dealing with it. He was like, I was like, look, like the suspension's gone in my rear wheel. I can't drive my car. I'm gonna appeal this anyway. And he was just like, I'll put in your notes that like you're gonna appeal it, blah, blah, blah. But yeah, how unfortunate.
It's fucking cold. The guy's here. I've had to use the dog blanket because I'm cold. So, I'm back. Okay. Safe and sound. My car has been taken away. I'm gonna take this little rascal on his second walk of the day. I have spent the whole day looking like an absolute troll. Should we go out? Okay, buddy. Okay, don't give a shit about coffee. Bearing in mind Hendrix is this tiny dog. I have this giant, like 2 foot long ball launcher. This tiny mentalist. I've hit a really hard period craving. So I ordered from Zap. I've tried most of these very quick delivery services, and Zap are probably the best. So I got Kinder Bueno, some Ritz crackers. I really wanted mini cheddars, but they didn't have them, so these were had to do. Hot cross bun. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Oh, great. I saved it in the nick of time. So these are not just hot cross buns, these are Gale's hot cross buns. I also got some Haribo strips. What else did I get? Some dog food, because I love to eat dog food. Just kidding. Some Parmesan. I have a real like craving for broccoli and also pasta. So this is my period craving haul. And also they gave me some free, they keep giving me free candy canes. It's kind of why I keep ordering from them.
My period cravings come like on so suddenly. I'll be like, oh yeah, like mine haven't been that bad this month. And then suddenly they'll just be like, and it'll hit me like a ton of bricks. And I don't necessarily, usually it's for something savory. Like I'm really like carby, like something cheesy. Usually like maybe Mexican or fried chicken. But then the sweet cravings hit as well. So this is why I've covered all bases. I've got kind of like sweet carbs with the hot cross buns. Love butter. Savory with the cheese crackers and the pasta. Sweet with Kinder Bueno, but like chocolate sweet. And then I've got fizzy, sweet, gummy sweet with the Haribo strips. So,
would you like to try a little bit of hot cross bun? I'm quite glad that he doesn't like it, because this is quite frankly the best hot cross bun I've ever had.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! So I actually look like a different person again now. I've looked like several different people in this vlog. I air wrapped my hair. Oh, it feels so good. It's the first time I've done it in like a while now, and it feels so good. I just love it. But oh my god, so you know the Chanel heart bag that like everyone's obsessed with from the spring summer collection? It's insane. Like everyone wants one, very hard to get. There's two versions. There's the handbag size, and then there's the small leather goods size, which is not big enough to fit in anything more than like a lipstick and a few other pieces, but it's still like mega cute. So I'm gonna have to bring the camera in closer because my arm hurts from doing lots of push-ups and stuff earlier. So strong. Basically, so it comes in the two sizes, and I really want the black handbag size, and I also want the white small leather good size. I have like obviously registered my interest with my sales assistant at Chanel a while back, and she just messaged me today to say this. Oh my god, I'm so happy. I have been like so obsessed. Oh my god, the resale for these bags is insane. That's that. So I just thought I'd let you know. I'm really excited. So I don't know when to go pick it up. Might have a little look at maybe going today or tomorrow. I'm not here this weekend. I'm going back to my parents' house this weekend, so we'll see.
Oh my god, it's happening. It's happening. I'm going to Chanel. I don't know what to wear. To be honest, I usually just show up wearing like... You know what? Actually, the problem is I don't ever know what to wear anymore. Because it's just cold, man. Apparently, if they see anything heart-shaped, like anything heart-shaped on the floor, people just go crazy. So I have to do this in private and secrecy.
Oh my god, I'm back. And I've got the bag. I will unbox it, I think maybe tomorrow morning, because I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it yet. I just feel like the light, we're about to lose the light. It's getting dark, it's getting late. And by late, I mean it's turning into about 7 o'clock. Oh my god, it's still so light, even though it's 7 o'clock. I love when daylight savings happen. But anyway, I'll unbox it tomorrow. And I'm gonna show it in a separate video, to be honest. So, so funny. Morning, guys. I'm about to film an unboxing of my Chanel, my new little Chanel baby. So I need to obviously make myself look cute. I've lost my liquid eyeliner, so I'm having to like do a dry eyeliner situation. A dry eyeliner, don't I think I am? It's not terrible. So I had an ASOS order arrive and I want to show you some things that I got from it. So we've got this little top. It's so cute. I just think it's like, it's a really fun, playful top, but without being too in your face, because it's like obviously black and white. So if it was like colorful, I'd be like, whoa, this is a bit much. But because it's like black and white, it makes it like a real like perfect combo. Then we've got this top, which is also very cute. I kind of feel like I should have got it maybe in the smaller size. I've undone this just because of how I want to wear it. Just because I kind of feel like I would have liked it if it fitted a bit tighter up top. So I might exchange this. This is from ASOS and it had potential, but I think if they bring out the petite, it will just fit me that little bit nicer. Like, this is fine, but I just don't love it. Also, I sized down to a size 6. So I just always feel like with smock styles like this, especially if you're small framed, like it helps to size down a little bit, but I still feel a little bit swamped by it. So I was meant to be going out shooting with Yasmin and like, this is so stupid. Shit, man, she's really hungry. I'm like during my period, it's 2 days late, my PMS is like, I'm very, very, very sensitive at the minute. This video just came on, like, my TikTok Explore feed, and it fucking ruined me. I'm gonna show you the video so you understand that I'm not just insane and a crybaby. This is, like, actual emotional damage. Must have been a deadly kiss. I just don't know what it is about things like that. I'm just happy scrolling on TikTok, like, this is funny, huh? This is funny, and then see this, and then I'm like, and I just sobbing, like, really sad. I really want more dogs. I really want to go and adopt loads of dogs, but I just don't have the lifestyle for it right now. Oh, one day. Okay, I've redone my makeup, and I'm about to go out and shoot content. I keep losing makeup. I don't know where it goes. I put it all here, but certain things just keep disappearing every day, something goes. Okay, I found one, I found two other things. I don't know where the other things are, but I'm sure it'll arrive back at some point. Come on, Chanel, women's stuff that like makes my skin nice and glowy. Oh my God, I just don't understand. Like, it's a proper like squeezy thing. It's not the kind of thing that just like goes missing. It's not like a little like eyeliner or something like that. Like, it's a full thing, glass bottle with, oh my fucking god, it's right here. Let me show. Oh my god, this is a poltergeist. I'm gonna have to go back and look at this footage and see if it was there before, because like, I swear it wasn't here.
She's there. There she is.
Oh, also need to go pick up my car, which means I can go home this weekend. I can drive back and see my parents, which will be so nice. I'm really excited to go back this weekend. Yes.
So it's Friday.
It's freezing. That's
freezing. We went shooting. It didn't go very well. So now we're going to pick up home. Oh, we've spotted a Pomeranian. Oh my god, it's very cute. Oh my god, it's so cute. Oh, this would look very cute though. Gotta be very honest. Oh my god, imagine. It's Hendrix's birthday next month. Oh my god, Hendrix has been so cold at night the past few nights. He's like really snuggled into me in bed, like literally like snuggling with me like a little baby. It's so cute. This will probably do the trick. Yeah, I think my mum will appreciate this one.
Are we going to grandma's house? Are we gonna go to grandma's house tonight? I don't think he knows exactly. He knows who grandma is, but I don't think he knows what her name means. But he'll be excited when he knows like exactly where we're going. Are we going to grandma's?
Okay, just about to set off. He's very excited. Look how, I'm sorry, but I'm going home for like a weekend. I have so much stuff. Granted, most of this is returns that I need to do. And also, minis are such small cars. They're like the smallest cars ever. So that definitely doesn't help. So, yeah.
Hi, Sashiken. Hi, Sashi. You're looking old. So this is Sasha. She's a Berman cat.
You ready for the ball?
Good morning, guys. Sorry, I've been just chilling with my parents. I haven't really done much. Look at this little monster.
Can you just have a little look? It's got some really small pieces of stuff. And then at this side. Oh, you can see it through there. Baby. Oh, he's saying no. He's saying no. Oh my god, I went to bed at 9 o'clock last night. My parents were like, are you okay? I was like, this is actually what I do. This is the life that I live.